see in the background here, I got my dad's shotgun back. Well, I've had it for about a month. Just haven't been in the mood to shoot it, because every time someone says it's fixed and shoot it, it's not fixed. So I figure it's a nice Sunday afternoon. Plus, I was looking for this because this is this is my dad's shotgun. Had the original manual, I guess you can say, operation. And it tells you about the heavy loads and the light load. And I wanted to make sure I didn't screw up, because supposedly when I first shot this back almost 2 years ago, that my friend's dad, who's a gunsmith for almost 50 years, so I probably had the rings in the wrong places. The friction ring, when I was shooting the light load, because at that time I didn't have light loads. All I had was bird shots and so on and so forth. So he said that's probably what the cause of it broke on part of the extension of the barrel. So who knows? I don't remember. So I just wanted to make sure, like, when he fixed it, it didn't fix. So I took it to a gunsmith back in, I think, a week before Thanksgiving. And I waited through the holidays. I waited till after New Year's, probably 1st of February, to find out what was going on. They said, oh, you know, the holidays, busy, blah, blah, blah. Well, long story short, it took 6 months for them to even look at it. And this is what they wrote on it, the gunsmith, because I guess they kind of outsourced it. They didn't really have a gunsmith at the place that I went to. It just said, I'm assuming it says, recut barrel, R-I-N-C-O-T, maybe, ring cut, I don't know. And it says T-E-G-T, maybe, or, I don't know. You can read it for yourself. We left a message. He wasn't going to charge me, so. Well, that's nice of him. I mean, it took 6 months. I was told it was going to take a few weeks for them to look at it and get back to me. And I don't know what happened. I don't know if he didn't want to be bothered, because no one really knew what was wrong. I told him what would happen. I got another barrel. Couldn't recoil. This is what he did. And I'm getting ready to shoot and see what happens. So this is, like I said, this will be another part of a video that I'll append to it. And I got my, I have it set up for the high load, so I'll shoot some buck shots and see what happens. And then the low brass bird shots, I have to change the rings out, and I'll show you that shortly. All right, talk to you later, bye. All right, well, gonna put one round of the double-aught buck shots into my dad's shotgun, so. Before I do that, make sure the safety's on before I. Alright. And like I said, when it happened before, the gun recoiled and just stayed back, the barrel into the chamber, and it stays back and won't reject the shell or load another one. But I'm not going to load one more than one, because then it's a pain in the butt trying to get it out. And excuse me, I've been having sinus allergies, so I may cough a few times during this video. But I'm gonna put one in, and we'll see what happens when I shoot. Oh, gotta get my ear protection, my new, I showed in the previous video. Let's turn it on, see how well it works. It's kinda neat, because you hear yourself talking, which is the purpose of these, because the other ones I can't hear what you're saying. I'll be going, what, what? Or I'll have one ear out talking, then I forget when I shoot, I'll leave one ear open, so. All right, I'm just gonna hope for the best. Get this camera in just a tad better. And we're live. And we'll see what happens. Oh, it ejected. Yeah, it's one. Well, I heard my son say something, but I didn't hear what he said. I heard something in the background. So it got it out. It worked. I'll try more than one. All right, I'll pause this and see what happens. All right, well, I figure I'd do a standing one, because I'm going to put two rounds in. Figure I'd go back to back and see what happens. I was really tickled pink that it ejected that round. Now, after I'm done here, I will try the bird shots, but I'm just going to do one rapid fire. I'm not going to put a total of three in, because I don't want any, like I said, if there are issues, then I'll have ammo stuck in here. So, safety's on. I'll put one in. Then I'll put the one into the, all right, like I said, safety is on. turn on my new let's see what happens. I'm kind of happy. We'll see. I'm just going to shoot out in the field. I don't want to shoot into my steel targets because last time I did that, the one with the next to the heart, I get in the camera, kind of warped or weakened the shepherd hook a little bit. So I'm just going to shoot out in the field and see what happens. All right. Damn it. Knew it was going to happen. Well, as you can see, came back. There's the other round. So I don't know what's going on. So much for my excitement for a few minutes. That's it. That's all I have to talk about right now. Bye. Well, I just want to show a little bit of a close-up of, like I said, the barrel's back in the chamber. Here's the other shotgun shell that I didn't, the other one didn't eject, so it's still in the barrel. I'm going to try to take this apart. The problem is this thing is a pain in the butt. Even if I take it apart at the magazine area, let me see if I zoom out a little bit. No. I can never get it out without tinkering, but I will give it a shot. I'm not going to videotape it because it may take me, I don't know, that long, 5-10 minutes to get the barrel pulled out. Now, I don't know if this is normal, if the shell, I don't know. Like I said, it shot. Of course, the barrel came back. I didn't find the ejected shell. So I'm assuming it's still in here. And I'll find out shortly. All right, I'm gonna try to push the ammo back into there so that I can push this. Where's that button at? See, the problem is, since the barrel is already down in here, I can't push this down to get this out. So, all right, I'm gonna pause this again, and I'm gonna try to yank on this. Cause I did it once over a year ago before I even took it to the second gunsmith, and then I tried to shot it again, and I got stuck, and I pulled, and then pain in the butt. Anyways, all right, I'm gonna stop this, cause it's gonna be a bear. All right, I got partly, I think, I tapped on this until this finally came up, but I don't think this is quite, here's the old shell. As you can tell, as I told you, it was still in the barrel. Let me empty the other round here, turn it around. It's pretty much, I don't know what the heck, I can't even, there's a little, I don't know what part of that, what that is down there, if you can see it. Can't even get the, if I can get this shell out, let me take this rings off because this is the first ring I was talking about. Remove this so I don't. Alright. See the bolt? Okay. Push this back up in here. I can push this button. See, I can't even. Something's really messed up. Any input, this sucks. I'm always ticked off when it doesn't quite work right. I got it taken apart. I got a video. Maybe if I find another gunsmith, any input, I'll put something on Facebook. Anybody in my area can recommend a gunsmith that will give it one more try. Like I said, something's messed up with this bolt system, I guess. If I can't, usually, you know, you push this button. This button, you can at least get the ammo. Let me see. If I can slide it out. You can see in there, it's... I'm going to pause this because I don't want to videotape and groan and moan and complain. All right, I forgot about this. I think there's a barrel safety latch here that I don't want to get my fingers crunched, but if I push this out a little bit, there we go. Now I should be able to get this out. Sure you were able to come out before. Put these back in. Hang on. Let me watch this. Push this back in above this. All right, I'm gonna hold this. I'm gonna get my fingers crunched. I mean, oh, that sucked. Damn it. Almost need another set of hands. Oh, at least I didn't puncture a hole, but that put a little dent. Oh, it blows. All right, come on. Okay, I don't know why now this gadget right there is preventing the shell to come out. I think that's what kicks out. Again, I'm not a gunsmith, people. I watch YouTube. Let's see if I'm lucky getting this sucker out. God damn, I hate this son of a bitch. Alright, I'm taking a 10-minute break. This is ticking me off. Alright, that's gonna leave a mark. Nice little bruise, nice little. Anyway, sucker finally got it out. Just doesn't look right, guys. Something just isn't jiving. But anyways, I got it out. I'm gonna get a gunsmith, show this video. If I can find somebody else. I have a cousin of mine that mentioned somebody can do work over in PA, so maybe I'll take it there and have him look. But anyways, that's my dilemma. Shot it once, no problem. Tried to load it, it seems like it shot, it either didn't eject in time for this to really, I don't know the mechanism, what causes what, first, second. You know, this of course has to eject before this one loads, but as you can saw in the previous video, this was still here, this was still in the barrel. The barrel was pushed all the way down. You know, the barrel was, you know, down into here. So I don't know, that's my dilemma, guys. Thought maybe, I don't know. Bummed out again. Well, at least I got around to testing it. Maybe it's maybe if I only shoot one lousy round at a time in this semi, I'll be okay, but I don't know. Anyways, sorry for rambling. Thanks for watching. Bye.